Hello students. I'm posting this short video on a concept called basis risk, which is something that we come across in the chapters of futures. What exactly is basis risk? How does it arise? How is it calculated? Are some of the things that we would have a look at in this video. I hope you find this video useful, and without any further delay, let's get on to this. Now, to understand basis risk, we first have to understand what is the meaning of a hedge. Now, what exactly do we mean by an hedge? Hedge is an investment undertaken to offset the adverse movement in a primary investment. इसका मतलब क्या है? इसका मतलब ये है कि आपका एक primary investment है, जिसको protect करने के लिए आप एक hedge transaction में enter करते हो. So, the idea being that अगर आपका primary investment में loss हो रहा है, then your future position should generate profit which should be sufficient to offset the loss which you are incurring in your primary positions. Now, in an ideal situation, the adverse movement in the value of the asset will be exactly offset by a favorable movement in the hedge. Matlab, agar aapka primary position mein 100 rupiya ka loss hai, to future position mein exactly 100 rupiya ka profit aana chahiye. But does this really happen? And if it does not happen, then why does it not happen? What if the adverse movement in the value of the asset is not exactly offset by a favorable movement in the hedge? Like I said, आपका asset में 100 रुपया का loss है, लेकिन futures में 100 रुपया का profit नहीं हो रहा है. Now, this is where the concept of basis risk comes in. So now, we get into the concept behind basis risk. What do we mean by basis risk? Basis risk is the financial risk that offsetting investment in a hedging strategy will not experience the price change of the same amount in opposite direction from each other. मतलब आपने जो offsetting investment किया, that is जो hedge किया है, उधर से profit या loss will not be either sufficient or it will be more than the loss or profit that you are incurring in the primary position. It is the inherent risk that the trader takes when hedging a position by taking a contrary position such as futures contract. It is accepted in an attempt to hedge away price risk. मतलब ये मान के चला जाता है कि हम जब price risk को hedge करने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं, तो हमारा कुछ तो loss होने वाला है. There is going to be some amount which the hedge is not going to cover. What does this mean? Let's take an example. Suppose soya spot prices are trading at 55 rupees a kg as of today. लेकिन आपका purchases 3 महीने के बाद है, so as a result you would want to enter into a 3-month futures which right now is trading at 58 rupees a kg. Which means, agar aap future transaction enter karte hain, toh you will be locking in the prices at 58 rupees a kg. So 55 se 58 ka jo movement hai, wo toh aap avoid nahi kar sakte ho, wo toh aapko lena hi padega. So that loss you have to incur. So if you enter into a contract, a future contract at 58 rupees, that means the price is getting locked at 58 and not 55. Now this difference between 55 and 58 is what is known as one of the basic risk. So here in this case, the basis risk is rupees 3, that is 55 minus 58. And this risk of rupees 3 is acceptable to a hedger in an attempt to freeze his price at 58. Matlab, ye 3 rupiya toh maan ke hi chal raha hai. Ki main 55 pe toh lock nahi kar paunga. I'll be able to lock my price at 58. Now, one of the key reasons for this happening is that we know that future price is nothing but spot plus interest. So, spot to aaj ka price hai, whereas I am trying to lock the price for a future period. So, and future ka jo price hoga, that will be spot plus something. So, mera jo price lock hoga, that will be at spot plus something. So, ye jo plus something ka loss hai, ye to mujhe incur karna hi padega. Right? And another important thing that we need to realize at this point or remember at this point in time is that future price tends to converge with the cash price on expiry, right? So on the date of expiry, the future price will be equal to the cash price. And ye jo difference hai, ye dheere 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 reduce hota jayega. So that on the future date or on the expiry date, the price of future will be equal to the cash price. Let's take an example. Let us presume that the current market price of a commodity is rupees 1000 and you intend to purchase the commodity after 2 months, but you apprehend that the price of the commodity is likely to increase in the intervening period. So you purchase a 2 month future contract on the commodity, which is trading at 1100. The price of the commodity turns out to be 1700 on the expiry. So now to summarize this, commodity ka aaj ka price 1000 rupees hai. और आपको ये कमोडिटी खरीदना है 2 महीने के बाद, पर आपको लगता है कि 2 महीने के बाद जब आप ये कमोडिटी खरीदने के लिए जाओगे उसका प्राइस बढ़ जाएगा, तो आप क्या करते हो, यू परचेज अ 2 मंथ फ्यूचर कॉन्ट्रैक्ट एंड दिस 2 मंथ फ्यूचर कॉन्ट्रैक्ट इज ट्रेडिंग टुडे एट 1100. नाउ लेट अस सी व्हाट हैपेंस इफ द प्राइस ऑफ द कमोडिटी टर्न्स आउट टू बी 1700 ऑन एक्सपायरी. सो ऑन डे 1 यू विल परचेज द कमोडिटी फ्यूचर एट 1100 एंड ऑन डे 60 दैट इज एट द एंड ऑफ 2 मंथ्स दैट इज ऑन एक्सपायरी you will sell that is square of the commodity future at 1700, because remember the commodity price on expiry is trading at 1700. So therefore the future price, as we know, will converge with the spot price on expiry. So this future will also be trading at 1700. So you've purchased the commodity future at 1100 and you're selling it off at 1700, making a profit of 600 rupees. So aapka broker jo hai aapko 600 rupees ka check de dega, but aapko to commodity chahiye. So आप क्या करोगे, यू विल गो इन द स्पॉट मार्केट एंड परचेज द कमोडिटी एट 1700, विच इज द स्पॉट प्राइस ऑफ द कमोडिटी ऑन दैट डे. नाउ व्हाट विल बी द कॉस्ट ऑफ द कमोडिटी टू यू. आपने 1700 रुपीज दे के कमोडिटी खरीदा, लेकिन 600 रुपये का चेक तो आपको ब्रोकर से मिल गया, विच मीन्स आपका नेट कॉस्ट ऑफ द कमोडिटी इज 1100, विच मीन्स बाय एंटरिंग इनटू द फ्यूचर कॉन्ट्रैक्ट यू हैव इफेक्टिवली फ्रोजन द कॉस्ट एट 1100. राइट, बट एक चीज नोटिस कीजिएगा, स्पॉट प्राइस इज 1000 बट आपका प्राइस जो लॉक हो रहा है वो 1100 है. सो ये जो 100 रुपया का डिफरेंस है, दिस इज द बेसिस रिस्क विच यू नो दैट एनी वे यू आर गोइंग टू इनकर इवन इफ यू एंटर इन टू अ फ्यूचर कॉन्ट्रैक्ट. तो आपका जो प्राइस है वो फ्यूचर कॉन्ट्रैक्ट में एंटर करने से भी वो 1000 रुपया में लॉक नहीं होने वाला है, वो 1100 रुपया में लॉक होने वाला है. इट्स गोइंग टू गेट लॉक्ड एट 1100 रुपीज. राइट, now this whole concept of locking in the price at 1100 was based on the fundamental assumption that you know the future price and the spot price will converge. But what if they do not converge? Then it obviously means that the adverse movement in the price of the asset will not be matched by an offsetting movement in the hedge, implying that the hedge will not be 100% efficient. Matlab aapka primary position mein loss ho gaya say 200 rupaye ka, lekin aapka hedge jo hai utna profit generate nahi kar pa raha hai. Now, there are a couple of reasons why it might not happen. Let's look at the reasons. One of the primary reasons why it doesn't happen is that the expiry date of the future does not correspond to the period of the hedge required. Now, let us say that today is January and you want to purchase the goods on March 31st. Now, ideally, you would want to buy the future which is expiring on March 31st. Let us again say that March 31st ka jo futures hai, wo market mein trade nahi ho rahe. Market mein jo futures trade ho rahe hain, wo June ke ho rahe. सो अब आपको जून का फ्यूचर्स खरीदना पड़ेगा, लेकिन आपको माल तो खरीदना है ऑन मार्च 31st. सो ऑन मार्च 31st व्हाट विल यू डू, यू विल बाय द गुड्स फ्रॉम द स्पॉट मार्केट एट द स्पॉट प्राइस प्रिवेलिंग ऑन मार्च 31st एंड यू विल हैव टू स्क्वायर ऑफ योर पोजीशन इन द फ्यूचर्स. बट नाउ रिमेंबर दैट द फ्यूचर विल नॉट बी ट्रेडिंग एट द स्पॉट प्राइस, बिकॉज रिमेंबर दिस इज नॉट द एक्सपायरी डेट ऑफ द फ्यूचर. द फ्यूचर स्टिल हैज गॉट अप्रैल, मई एंड जून, 3 महीना अभी उसमें जाने के लिए है. सो उसका जो प्राइस है वो स्पॉट प्राइस में ट्रेड नहीं हो रहा होगा. सो ऑब्वियसली व्हाट विल हैपन इज कि आपका जो कमोडिटी में जो प्राइस इंक्रीज हुआ है और फ्यूचर्स में जो प्रॉफिट आएगा, दे विल नॉट मैच. राइट, एंड द सेकेंड रीजन कुड बी दैट द कोरिलेशन बिटवीन द कमोडिटी एंड द हेज इज नॉट मूविंग इन टैंडम. मतलब स्पॉट प्राइसेस एक अलग तरीके से मूव कर रहा है एंड द फ्यूचर प्राइस इज मूविंग इन अ डिफरेंट वे. So there is a possibility that the spot price has moved up by 200 rupees, but the future price has not moved to that extent. So as a result, what will happen is you will get adversely affected on the spot prices, but aapko futures mein utna profit nahi milega. So this is another reason why it doesn't work. The first type of the risk, where the expiry date of the future does not correspond with the period of the hedge required, is called as a period risk. And the second type of risk, where the spot price and the future price do not move in tandem, that is the correlation between the spot and the future is somewhere going wrong. Now that is called as a product risk. Students, I hope you found this short video on this small concept useful. And I hope to be back with some more short videos like this on small concepts which will be very useful in finance some other time, some other day. Ciao.